Hello guys, this is Suyesh here, and now in this video we'll be discussing in the section of our general pharmacology, and we'll be discussing the routes of drug administration, and we will be continuing in our fourth lecture of routes of drug administration. In the previous video, as we have discussed the parenteral routes, in which we have discussed the injectable routes. Okay, so we have discussed in the first video this chart, you remember? So injectable routes we have discussed. So now in this video we'll be discussing the non-injectable routes. Okay, so nasal, inhalation and transdermal route. Okay, so watch my previous videos before coming to this video. I'll attach in the I button. Okay, so let's start with the parenteral non-injectable routes. Meaning is clear, the route is not means the route is the administration of drug is not through the injection. Okay, but it comes under the parenteral section. Okay, so parenteral meaning, as I've told you in the previous video also, in the first video also, that the absorption is without GIT. Okay, absorption away from GIT or beyond GIT, you can say absorption beyond GIT. Okay, so there's a basic meaning. So it will be bypassing the liver, and the bioavailability will be high as compared to the enteral routes or the oral and rectal routes. Okay, so let's start with the first. We have the nasal route. Okay, in nasal route first we have to discuss the nasal route. So in the section of nasal route, we actually administer the drug through the mucous membrane. So in the nose you can administer the drug. In the nose there are small blood vessels and capillaries from which you can administer the drug inside the nose, and from there it will be directly absorbed inside the systemic circulation. So you don't have to go through the that is the bypass, that is the first pass metabolism. Okay, so it is one of the disadvantages with this routes. Okay, so now let's discuss the advantages. So we will be bypassing the digestive pH also, GI pH, that can clear some drugs. Okay, and we will be also bypassing the first pass metabolism by the liver. Okay, so this is the first advantage. And now we can give only certain drugs. Okay, we can't give every drug through this route. So we have the some specific drugs like GnRH agonist. So this drugs actually suppresses your ovulation. Okay, and decreases the level of estrogens and progesterones in female. Okay, so we have many drugs under this. Later on you will study about all this. Okay, then we have the desmopressin, like vasopressin. It is a synthetic drug. Okay, in the section, same section, vasopressin, what vasopressin does, and calcitonin. So these are the three drugs which we give through nasal route. And one of the more important point is that also used in the patient with allergic rhinitis. So the persons who are inflammation in the nose, okay, or allergy inside the nose, so in that patients also we can use a nasal route for the drug administration. Okay, so this was actually the nasal route. Okay, so now let's move on to the inhalation route. Okay, so it is somewhat similar, but some specific drugs are given through the inhalation route. Okay, now let's start with the inhalation route. So inhalation, by the meaning, it is clear that you will inhale some drugs. Okay, so the drugs can be in the form of liquid also or in the form of gas also, like you inhale and exhale oxygen and carbon dioxide. In that way you will now inhale the drug. Okay, so that can be in the volatile liquid form that I have written, and gases form. Clear? And what drugs are given by this route? Specifically, we actually give the anesthetic drugs. Okay, general anesthetic drugs. Okay, when we have to actually suppress the respiratory system. Okay, and suppress the pain. So for anesthesia, we actually use general anesthesia. We actually use this route. Okay, like nitrous oxide we have. So all these drugs comes under the inhalation route. Okay, so later on you will study all the general anesthetic drugs. Okay, now now the second point is that action and absorption is very rapid, as similar to the IV bolus. So the point is that the absorption will be very rapid and action will be very fast here. And like your IV route, as we have discussed in the intravenous section, that in intravenous section we can give the drug in bolus form, that is in a large dose. So that much rapid the absorption is in the case of inhalation route. Okay, similar. And third point is that if the drug administration is stopped, then drug diffuses back and eliminated in the expired air. So the meaning is that if the if you stop the drug, which is the patient which is inhaling, then the drug, the extra drug which has been diffused inside, now that drug will be expired through air, means it will come back and it will be exhaled out by the patient. Okay, in the carbon dioxide which you exhale, with that the drug will be also diffuse back and exhaled out. So that is the meaning. So you can actually titrate the drug. So doses can be titrated. Okay, you can adjust the doses in this case. So this is also one of the disadvantages. एंड दिस ड्रग्स आर एक्चुअली बेसिकली इफेक्टिव इन द रेस्पिरेटरी डिसऑर्डर्स लाइक टारगेट ऑर्गन्स आर लंग्स. सो एक्चुअली दिस ड्रग्स एक्चुअली एब्जॉर्ब्स इन द एल्वियोलाई द लार्ज इट हैज़ अ लार्ज सर्फेस एरिया. सो सम ऑफ द ड्रग्स आर मीन्स मैक्सिमम ड्रग्स आर दैट इज absorbed inside the alveoli of the lungs. Okay, so target organ is lungs, so that is why they are more effective in the case of respiratory disorders, as they don't have to go through the oral route and then they will come to the pharmacological site of action. So in that case, if you have a lung disorder patient, you can directly use this route for the administration of the drug. Okay, so you can use in asthma. In asthma, as you know, the patient use the puffs, okay, in which we have the salbutamol, okay, beta adrenomimetic drugs, these are. Okay, so you will learn in the later videos, I will tell you, okay, in that autonomic pharmacology, after the general pharmacology. So in this asthma, we use actually salbutamol, the puffs the patient use who have dyspnea conditions. So in that patients, we can use this inhalation route and some chronic obstructive pulmonary diseases also. So I told you doses can be titrated and they have the fewer side effect as they directly goes the target organs, like in the case of respiratory disorders. So they will show lesser side effects, okay, and some irritant vapors can also cause inflammation in the respiratory tract also. So if the drug, some vapors are if some vapors have irritant, that they can also cause some inflammation inside the respiratory tract till the alveoli. Okay, so it depends on the drug, okay, the drug which you are administrating. If it is irritant drug, then it can cause lead to inflammation in the respiratory tract. So that is the inhalation route. I think it is covered. So this was the inhalation route. So main point is general anesthetic drugs we actually give through this route. Now we have the third route in this section, non-injectable route, is the cutaneous or transdermal patch. So meaning is clear. Now this drug will be administrating over the skin, okay, directly will be putting a patch like a bandage, you know. So similar like a bandage, we put a patch on the skin, and from there the drug is slowly, means very slow rate, the drug is released inside the capillaries and blood vessel, and through that it goes inside the systemic circulation. So absorption is very slow, okay. So the drug is released at a constant rate. So let's discuss the characteristics of this route. So drugs which are highly lipid soluble can be given, because the skin is made up of lipid bilayers. So you can't administer the any type of drug which is not a lipid soluble. So highly lipid soluble drug can be administered through this route, and which have lower bioavailability, like the drugs which have lower oral bioavailability. If the drug you are administering through the oral route and that drug has a very low bioavailability, then you can alternate the route and you can give through this route also, okay. And second point is that drug is applied on the skin for slow and the prolonged action. So as I told you, the drug is applied on the skin as a patch, and from there the drug is very slowly at a constant rate it is released, and it can show its effect around 1 to 2 to 3 days and somewhat about weeks also. So that is why the action can be prolonged also, and the drug releases very slow, okay. And liver is bypassed, as it is clear, it is a parenteral route, so it will be bypassed. So there will be no first pass metabolism, clear. And it is painless also, as you simply have to put the patch on the skin, so there is no pain as such, and it can be self-administration because a patient can put by on his own on the skin, clear. And systemic side effect is less, as it is directly absorbed through the skin, and it can directly reach to the pharmacological site of action where the effect is to be done, okay. So side effect is less. Now let's move on to disadvantages. So patient can be allergic, some patients can be allergic to the patches, okay. So they can be patches or allergic if they put that bandage on the skin, so those patient can be there, so it is disadvantage. And we can't grip the drug in large doses, means that limited to the drug given in small doses, not in large. Small doses drugs can't be given because it's a very slow release, so we can't give the drug in very small amount, so we have to give in the large doses. So small doses is contraindicated, and it is expensive also, that is the disadvantages. Now let's discuss the actually the diagram of the patch which we are having, and how is drug released slowly, and what are the structures in that transdermal patch. And that transdermal patch is actually called as transdermal therapeutic system, TTS, okay. So same thing, but it is just a overview of the transdermal patch, the diagram for the transdermal patch, how it is released, what are the layers in that bandage, you can say, or that patch, okay. So drug is delivered in the form of patch, as I told you, and delivered at a constant rate. This is an important point. into the systemic cerebellum via stratum corneum. This is a layer in the skin from there, from where your drug will be released at a constant rate. Clear? Now let's see the layers actually. So first layer, we have the backing film, drug reservoir. Then comes your rate controlling micropore membrane. So meaning is that how much amount of drug is released at a time, okay? So that will be controlled by this micropore membrane. And comes your adhesive layer from which you will just paste the patch on the skin. So there will be adhesive layer, and then above that will be outer layer. Like bandage, you have to peel off first layer, then you put on the skin. So that layer is called as outer layer in the transdermal patch. Now let's see it on the diagram. You can see, just consider this is my skin and you have put the patch, okay, like this. So backing film will be the first upper layer, okay, in which will be the drug will be present. That is called as drug reservoir. So first layer I told you, backing film. Then comes your drug reservoir, where drug will be stored. Then comes your micropore membrane, which will control the release of the drug. You can see this, pores are present, okay, from where the drug will be released very slowly and action will be prolonged, okay. So that is why this drug actually works around 2 to 3 days or somewhat about weeks also. Clear? Then comes your red one, is actually adhesive layer from which you will paste the transdermal patch on the skin, okay. So that is called as adhesive layer. And out of and the most outer is outer layer. The bandage, you see, first you have to peel off that layer on the sides, then you put on that. So that layer is called as outer layer. Clear? So this is actually the diagram from which the drug will be released, dotted one, slowly, and action will be prolonged. So the rate is controlled by this micropore membrane. And in adhesive layer, we have the first dose actually. So first dose, that is the first dose when you paste the drug, that is the patch on the skin. Then the first dose is actually released through this adhesive layer, and after that the drug is released from the drug reservoir and through the micropore membrane, okay, slowly. Clear? And sites where we can put the patch are chest, abdomen, buttocks, upper arm, mastoid region you can give. So these are the common sites where you put the transdermal patch. Clear? And what are the drugs you can give? Scopolamine and nitroglycerin. Scopolamine is an anticholinergic agent which is used in motion sickness, the patient who are having motion sickness, and in the patients with hypersalivation also. Okay, so anticholinergic actually decreases the production of saliva. So the patients who are hypersalivating, in that patients you can give scopolamine, and in main in the motion sickness. And nitroglycerin, as I told you, it given in prophylaxis of angina, okay, anginal pain, heart pain. So this was the last video on the routes of drug administration. I think it is clear. Okay, so if you like the video, do share and subscribe the channel. Thank you.